Hello everyone, once again welcome to PM Networking. Guys, today in this video we are going to configure time-based ACL. This is a very important topic. Many time interviewers asking scenario-based question from this topic, that how to configure access control list so that employee cannot access internet during office hour. Employee cannot access internet from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Or interviewer can ask you like this, how to configure ACL so that my employee cannot access my HTTP server or my FTP server during office hour. So this is my task for the day. Today I am going to perform this task. As you can see over here, this is my task. Configure a time-based ACL on R2. So on which router I am going to configure ACL on R2. So that configure time-based ACL on R2 so that the user on R1 cannot access R3 through telnet during 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Right? So my requirement is from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. these employee can't access R3 through telnet. Right? So first of all, let me configure IP. As you can see over here, between R1 and R2 I will run this network. Between R2 and R3 I will run this network, right? And I will configure ACL on R2 so that these employee can't access R3 through telnet during 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Right? After that, these user can access through telnet. Fine. First of all, let me show you IP configuration on PC1. So IP interface brief exclude unassign. Okay, so I have already configured IP address 10.1 over here, right? As you can see, 10.1 is IP address of this machine, 10.2 is IP address of this machine. Default gateway is 10.10. So on router 1, let me check. This is my router 1. So IP interface brief exclude unassign. Okay, so there is no any IP configuration. Let me configure IP interface F0/0, no shutdown IP address. So default gateway is 10.10. Let me configure 10.1.10 over here. Subnet mask 255.255.255.0, exit interface fast ethernet 0/1, and here I will run 2L network. So IP address will be 2L.1.1.1 255.255.255.0. And for connectivity, we can run any protocol. Let me configure EIGRP for connectivity, right? Router EIGRP AS number 100 and network 0.0.0, right? Configuration of R1 is done. Let me configure R2. Configure terminal interface F0/0, no shutdown. IP address will be 12.1.1.2 255.255.255.0, exit interface F0/1, no shutdown. Here I will run 23 network 23.1.1.1 255.255.255.0, exit. Now let me run EIGRP for connectivity. Router EIGRP 100 and network 0.0.0. fine. So IP EIGRP neighbor. So IP EIGRP neighbor. Fine. So IP root EIGRP. You can see there is 10 network. Fine. Now let me configure R3. So go to configure terminal. After that, interface fast ethernet 0/0, no shutdown. And IP address is 23.1.1.2 255.255.255.0. Router EIGRP 100 and network 0.0.0. Now I have connectivity. Can I ping 23.2 from PC1? 23.1.1.2. So yes, I am able to ping. Success rate is 100%. Now let me configure telnet service on router 3. So command will be line vty 0 and password is suppose 123 and no login. So it will not ask you for password. Fine. In global configure mode, username age Cisco 123, and password is also Cisco 123. Okay, let me show you, am I able to tailnet R3 or not, tailnet 23.1.1.2. So yes, you can see I am able to access R3 through tailnet. Okay, now I am going to configure ACL on R2, time based ACL. So first of all, how to check time? So clock, this command will show you time. So this is my current time. 14th June 2022, 0 hour 30 minute and 21 second. Okay, so first of all, we need to define time range. Time range is from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Okay, so 09:00 to here you need to define time. Time range name. So suppose time range name is time, right? Or you can write anything. Suppose time range name is CCNA. After that, if you will put question mark, you will find two options. One is absolute and one is periodic, right? Absolute means you can define a specific time and date, right? And periodic means you can define a periodic time. So here we need to define periodic time. Periodic, after that weekday or weekend or Sunday, Monday. So on every weekday I am going to configure ACL. I am going to configure ACL for every weekday, and timing will be from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. 6 p.m. means 18:00. Fine, you can verify it. So time range, you can see there is one periodic time range for weekdays from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. right? Now I need to create ACL. So access list 101, you have to configure extended ACL. Okay, extended ACL, after that deny TCP traffic, right? Tailnet is using TCP, so we can deny TCP traffic. After that source can be anything, destination can be anything. After that time range is CCNA, name of my time range is CCNA, enter. After that access list 101, permit IP any, right? Now we need to apply this ACL on interface fast ethernet 0/0, IP access group 101 and direction in. Okay, now so time range, first of all, now my time range is inactive because there is from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. and now time is so clock, now time is 12:13, right? So I can access router 3 through tailnet. Yes, let me change the time on R2. Okay, so command will be clock set. In privilege mode you will run this command, clock set, and let me set time 10 a.m. okay, 10 hour 00 second, 00:00 minute and 00 second. After that date is 06, then month is June, after that year is 2022, right? Now so time range, now you can see this is active, right? And you can verify ACL as well. So access list, now my ACL is also active. So now PC1 and PC2 can't access R3 through tailnet. You can see destination unreachable, right? Now this user can't access R3 through tailnet, but after 6 PM. Let me set time 7 PM over here. Let me configure time 7 PM. So command is clock set, and 7 PM means 19:00 minute 00 second. Date is 06 June 2022. Now show access list. Now you can see my access list is inactive. Because why access list is inactive? Why access list is inactive? Because my time range is inactive, you can see, right? So in inactive time, this user can access telnet server. You can see I am able to access, right? There is no password. Let me configure enable password over here. Enable password 123. Enable password is 123. So IP interface brief exclude unassigned. You can see now I am able to access telnet service. But if I will change the time again, let me set clock set and 4 PM. 4 PM means 16:00 minute 00 second. Date is 06 June and year is 2022. So access list, you can see my access list is again active. So this user can't access R3 through telnet. You can see telnet 23.1.23.1.1.2. trying destination unreachable. Okay guys, so this is very important topic, how to configure time based ACL. Or interviewer can ask you how to configure access control list so that these user can't access internet during office hour, during 9 AM to 6 PM, or these user cannot access my FTP server, my HTTP server, my DNS server, my DHCP server, right? So there can be different scenario, right? An interviewer can ask you scenario based question from this topic as well. Okay, so hope this video is helpful for you, and if you like this video, please hit on like button guys. If you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe this channel PM Networking. We will meet soon in next video. Till then, stay safe. Bye bye guys. That's all for today.